All right, there are things that you can do right now to lower your cholesterol and get kind of a nice start on a healthier life, including diet, exercise, quitting smoking.
Certain supplements can also help, but will they make a difference for your heart? There's one man ready to answer that question. It's Dr. Marc Gillinov of the Cleveland Clinic. So I got to tell you, so I had my health screening yesterday, and they said my HDL, I could do a little better on the HDL. So I know that I need to maybe exercise a little more, eat a few more better foods, you know, but these supplements that are out there, are they going to do anything for me?
This could be a really short segment because
the answer is
no.
Okay, back to you.
Ah,
yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
So more on the weather or something.
Right,
like that.
Right. Why are the claims out there that they would do something for you, though?
So what are some of the things, like we hear, garlic?
Fish oil?
Fish oil is huge.
That's good.
It's not good, but it's a huge industry.
Yeah.
Billion dollar industry. Good, okay.
No, fish oil, garlic, cinnamon, plant sterols, red yeast rice.
Turmeric, all that
stuff.
You go
to any CVS, Walmart, Target, and there's a gigantic area of supplements. And then within that area, there's the heart health section. And I can tell you right now, just keep walking.
Really?
The supplements do next to nothing for you. And in a recent study from Cleveland Clinic, 190 patients were randomly assigned to either you get a statin, that's like Lipitor, Zocor, Crestor, real medicine, or you get one of these supplements, including fish oil, garlic, et cetera. And they followed the patients for a month and then measured their LDL, the bad cholesterol. And the people who got a supplement, no change. The people who got a real statin, a medicine, 35% reduction.
Wow.
So statins save lives. Mm-hmm. Supplements drain your wallet.
Wow. And then you do have to be careful with a lot of these, especially fish oil. If you get in a car accident, you need surgery. There's a lot of things that it could probably harm you. So you're taking it if you think it can help you. But taking a bunch of supplements aren't necessarily a good thing. They can interact with other medications. They can interact with each other, too.
Fish oil in particular can increase your risk of bleeding. So we ask every patient who's going for surgery, are you taking any supplements, in particular fish oil or vitamin E? Stop those beforehand.
But unfortunately, you can't sometimes, it's not like you can elect every one of the surgeries that you have. If there's an emergency situation or, as I mentioned, a car accident or something, what do you do? Okay, so we're going to throw those away and not take those.
And fish oil comes in a perfectly palatable form. Have fish.
Yeah. And you're getting those natural benefits.
Yeah. Is there any benefit to some of these things outside of the heart? I mean, is there a benefit to even taking anything?
For the most part, not much to know.
Okay.
And the worst thing that happens is somebody decides, I'm not going to take the medicine that will make me better or will save my life. I'm going to skip the medicine and go all natural, whatever that means.
Yeah.
And if you forego something that really works and take something that does nothing, you leave yourself at risk for whether it's heart disease, stroke. Mm-hmm. There are lots of supplements you see on television for joint health as well.
Oh, yeah.
They may help a little bit.
A little bit,
a
but
little.
Not to make, I mean, you need improvement with all this stuff, especially with something like cholesterol.
Yes.
Why do you think there's such a thing? And I asked you a couple months ago, because I said, my thyroid doctor said I need to get on a statin, my cholesterol's starting to creep up. And I was working so hard to not do it. And you're like, just take it. Yeah. And honestly, it's the tiniest little pill, and I have had zero complications, zero symptoms. I think it's this almost stigma that, like, now you're stuck on cholesterol medicine. Why is that? Because honestly, and my levels dropped immediately.
Oh, they
so
work.
It's really helping. And then you even said, like, just take it every other day. And now I'm taking it every day, and it's fine. Seamless transition. I'm so glad I added it. Because now I can have all the pasta with the Alfredo sauce that I want.
Yeah, I don't think it's supposed to work that way, but... Yeah. I think people really just don't want to be on a prescription medicine.
Yeah.
And if you go to the supplement aisle and you get these things that are non-prescription, labeled all natural, nature's special medicine, it feels like I'm not really on a medicine.
True.
Even though it's a pill here and a pill from your doctor, and the pill from your doctor, the pill from your real pharmacy, is much more likely to work, to lower your cholesterol, to save your life. And gosh, by the time you get to be about, you're younger than I am, but by the time you get to be my age, 60 years old, virtually everyone is on some sort of low-dose statin, maybe a low-dose blood pressure medicine, maybe an aspirin in certain cases.
Yeah.
They're mostly innocuous, and they make you live longer.
100%.
Pretty good trade-off.
There's a lot of doctors I've met over the years that are like, if I have a patient by like 40, I start putting them on that. Todd?
Yeah. It's coming.
What did you learn from this session today after your appointment yesterday?
Well, thank you. I try to be. Well, I had my physical. I was doing pretty good about a month ago. So we'll see as things progress, and we'll keep monitoring it.
But diet and exercise are key, too, and that can really help.
Yes, and there's a growing movement to think of food as medicine. Yeah. It also tastes good.
I'm going to eat more fish, not fish oil.
More fish.
All right. Dr. Marc, thank you so much. Appreciate
thank
that.
You. And
great,
thanks, doctor.
Great information, too.